Every afternoon around 3.
Where are you?
Meg Doherty welcomes home her tribe.
Hi, guys.
She and her husband, Peter, all 4 children.
I can't open the door.
Those 4 faces fill the walls. Their laughter and personalities fill the home.
Oh, my goodness.
It's a life she wouldn't trade.
No.
And an opportunity she wants everyone to have.
Family's important. I can't imagine not being able to have a family when that's all you want to be. Well, as you can tell, she's always wanted a sister.
Which is why Meg's now pregnant a 5th time.
Let me get you a towel.
But the baby girl she's carrying won't be joining the Doherty family. Instead, she'll have a new home with her biological parents.
I just think it's a neat process, honestly. I want to just give someone a baby.
Meg is the oven, if you will.
I just want them to be there, and I just want them to take her, and I just want her to see them and hear their voice. And this is like, that's the moment I cannot wait for. That's the moment I was like so excited for.
A moment 14 months in the making.
Circle Surrogacy is what the agency that I chose, and so I just kind of reached out to them. And then, I don't know, just kind of was a whirlwind.
She read about Circle online, then sent in her application.
There's so much legal stuff that they do first. They need to get all of your medical records to make sure that you're okay to have like another baby just in general, and then somebody else's baby.
Rigorous screening into every aspect of who she is.
There was like 200 or 300 questionnaire about, I mean, literally like everything about you.
Once accepted, the next step, learning whose baby she would carry.
You have filled out your profile and you've sent pictures and described your lifestyle and all of those sort of things. And then they send you some matches that they think that you would like.
She found a family that fit on a day marked with meaning.
We actually talked to them on like Father's Day. So just, I don't know, just something about that just made it seem like the right time, like the right family, and everything just sort of fell in place then.
Meg then prepped her body as instructed by doctors at their fertility clinic. Small shots for a couple weeks.
The first part was I did these little needles. These ones were not that painful.
Then big shots once a day for up to 3 months.
Then we went to the big kahuna, and this one was not fun.
Meg said the hormone shots led up to the transfer of the parents' fertilized embryo into her body.
So basically tricking your body into thinking that it's pregnant before they actually implant the embryo.
An embryo from the intended parents put in place last October.
My due date is technically July 10th.
Meg says this has come with its share of questions.
It was a lot of just like, why? Why would you do that? Why would you, in a way, play God? You know, like, why would you mess with that? If they, you know, if they were supposed to have a baby, then they would have a baby.
Her response is simple.
I just say, God made the doctors who made it possible, so if he's okay with them being that smart to do it, then I don't see why it's bad.
They also had to explain it to their own kids.
We just kind of described that, you know, I was able to have all 4 of them in my tummy, and some people, you know, want to have a baby and they can't have it in their tummy for some reason, so I'm just going to hold their baby in my tummy for them, and then when she's born, they'll take it home.
Circle's website shows surrogate moms can earn tens of thousands of dollars. Meg said the money is nice, but it's not what motivated her.
Really, we're just trying to save it and, you know, put it to the side because it's unexpected. We're trying not to, like, actually use it.
Tito, come here!
2 more months before the little miss makes her arrival.
Now can I have one more?
Yes.
And though she won't be joining this family,
will you bring the trash can over here?
This mom is glad she's able to help another woman hold that title.
Anyone who knows me knows that this is real life, so.
Megan Dillard, Fox 4 News.